Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to tonight's NJCAA Region 21 contest with the visiting Mass Bay Community College and your Bristol Community College Bayhawks. The NJCAA Region 21 and Bristol Community College are committed to the ideals of good sportsmanship, safety, and fair play. We ask all fans, coaches, and players to show respect for the opposing team, game officials, and each other before, during, and after today's game. Your cooperation is greatly appreciated. And now for tonight's starting lineups, first with the visiting Mass Bay Community College. First, number one, Anthony Swain. Now, number five, Tevin Charles. Number 23, Cameron Jimenez Fox. Number 11, Zeke Gray Mardell. And number 10, Brandon Portillo. Mass Bay is coached by Mr. Bill Raynor. And now for your Bristol Community College Bayhawks. At guard, a freshman from Pawtucket, Rhode Island. He's number 14, Armani Baker. At the other guard, a freshman from Boston, Massachusetts, number 13, Jeremiah Ephraim. At center, a sophomore from Brocktown, Massachusetts, number 30, Jason Bing. At guard, a sophomore from Providence, Rhode Island, number 4, Josh Nelson. And rounding out the starting five for your Bristol Community College Bayhawks, at guard, a sophomore from Providence, Rhode Island, number 1, Jarrell Gomes. BCC is coached by Robert Delalue and assisted by Frank Stevenson, Joshua Rogers, and Brian Fernandes. Will everybody please rise for the playing of your national anthem?
Welcome in, everybody, to Bishop Connolly High School, Fall River, Massachusetts. I'm David Cardoza, and I'm along here with my colleague, Mr. Benjamin Arab Andrews. How you doing? I want to call you Benjamin Farabini for a second, but I know you all like that. So.
Yeah, exactly.
Well, I want to welcome everybody to this NJCAA contest, Region 21, between the Bristol Community College Bayhawks, who come in surging. 5-0 in January. They're 11-6, 9-4 in Region 21. Mass Bay also has a great record. They're 11-5, and they're 9-4 in Region 21. So we get a great matchup here between two great teams that are pretty hot. So again, we're at Bishop Connolly High School, the site of today's big contest here in Fall River, Massachusetts. We're ready for a tip, and it's going to go to Mass Bay. Bristol Community College wearing their white uniforms today with the green trimming. Mass Bay is in their, is that a navy blue?
That is a navy blue.
It is a navy blue, okay.
You'd be the guy who should know.
I should be familiar with that. Navy blue with a little white trimming. Here's Jeremiah Ephraim. Now they turn the ball over on their first possession. Ephraim on the drive to his left hand. Out to Nelson. Nelson on the drive. Scoops it up and in. Ooh, in the lane. There's going to be a foul on the center, Jason Bing, number 11. We're going to have trouble with this name, Ben. Ziu Gray Mundell.
Mundell, yep.
Yeah. I think I screwed it up in the pregame, but I think I was close.
Yes. A for effort.
A for effort. All right, we're just getting underway here. Okay, first free throw made by Ziu Mundell. That foul, I believe, was on the center, Jason Bing. Mm-hmm. Or actually, it looks like on the scoreboard, looks like it was on Jarrell Gomes.
Yep.
That ball chipped up, the second free throw missed. Coming away with it is the crafty Joshua Nelson.
He attacks the ball well every game.
Matt Bay in the zone. Here's Armani Baker. Takes it back out to Ephraim. Ephraim dribbles and doubles. Nice defense played by Mass Bay. Got to get a shot off. Up in. It's not going to hit the rim. Going to be a shot clock violation.
Yep.
The basket was no good. And Mass Bay will retain possession. Bay around the perimeter, open three, it's good. That's a three ball by number 10,
Brandon
Portillo. Giving Mass Bay an early lead here. Jarrell Gomes, sporting a new hairdo, puts it up in the lane and in. We're tied early on, 4-4. Oh, wide open underneath is Mundell, and he's going to get fouled, and it looks like he's going to be going to the line again.
Yeah. Very smart play by Mass Bay, getting a man under the basket, but got fouled on the shot, so still got a chance to go for two.
Yes, sir. He was wide open underneath there. And
yes, he was.
Bristol Community College had to retreat to get back there, and the foul is going to be on Armani Baker. So stepping up to the line for two is Mr. Mundell. He'll miss that one. Back-to-back misses now in consecutive times to the line for Mundell.
Yeah, now we'll see if he can sink this one.
BCC comes in here, averaging 84.4 points per game. So the Bayhawks are going to put points on the board. They're also shooting 48.4% from the field and 32.8% from three-point territory this season. So the second free throw was made by Mundell, giving Mass Bay the early 5-4 lead. Here's Gomes, top of the key, drives to the hole, can't get it to go. Loose ball, coming away with his Mass Bay. Number one, taking it to the hole. Oh, nice block.
Nelson.
Nice block coming out of nowhere as Nelson blocking Anthony Swain. On the other end, loose ball, it's going to go back to Mass Bay.
There it is.
So a whirlwind of things happening there. And coming into the game and coming out is Jeremiah Ephraim. Coming into the game is number three.
Rev Perez
from right here in Fall River, Massachusetts, went to Derby High School. He's in the game now for BCC. So, they try to lob it in to Mundell, but it was stolen away by Jason Bing. Here comes Perez, and there's going to be a foul on the floor. Yep. Foul is going to be on
number 10.
That's Brandon Portillo. Bayhawks looking to continue their winning streak. Winners of five straight. Yep. They've won 8 of their last 10 games. So tournament time is approaching tournament time.
Yes, it is.
Ooh, in the hole.
Yep.
Can't get it to go. Ooh. Nice pass. Nice pass to number one, Anthony Swain. Who was that on the assist?
BCC coming out playing that knee ball. Hopefully they'll start passing around a little bit more.
King, jumper from the elbow. Can't get it to go. Rebounded by number five, Tevin Charles, with the basketball. Oh, jumper. It's good. Cameron Jimenez-Fox with the jumper, giving them a 9-4 lead. It's going to be a tough contest. Rob Dale needs to call a timeout here.
Yep.
So Mass Bay coming in on the road and getting up to a good start. Matching BCC's intensity. And Mass Bay is no slouch, Ben. Coming, like I said, coming in here at 11-4. 11-5, 9-4 in the conference. And, you know, these two teams are at the top of Region 21, so this is going to be a big pivotal game.
Oh,
as we get down to the last couple games, the Bayhawks have one more home game that we know of next Tuesday.
Yeah.
So they're getting down to the last couple games before they, get ready for tournament time.
Definitely.
But Bristol Community College, we've been doing these games, Ben, in the last few games. We've seen the improvement that from November, December. You know, Rob Del Lue talks about getting better as the season goes along. His team usually not swift starters, but towards the end of the season, everything's going according to plan. You know, they start off kind of mediocre, hovering around 500, and in January, after Christmas break, really, they've been undefeated.
Yeah, they just blew up.
Yeah. And there's going to be a loose ball. Turnover, the ball's going to go back to BCC. Here's Rep Perez being guarded by Portillo. Josh Nelson for three. Coming off, it's going to be rebounded by Portillo. Anthony Swain with the basketball. Hands it to Mardal. Coming in with the left hand strong. Who's going to stop that guy? He's going for the basketball. Baker to Perez, getting underneath. So Nelson steps back, can't get it to go. Bing the rebound, strong move, puts it up and in. Battle of the big man here early. Jason Bing, number 30. The three-point shot coming off no good. Armani Baker with the rebound. Here's Jeff Perez. Finally, Jarrell Gomes, a three, it's good.
Megan,
Mr.
Easy.
Gomes with the three from the top of the key. BCC back in it, 11-9. BCC bench starting to get into it. Travel, it's gonna be steps. Took a step there. Cameron Jimenez-Fox with a turnover, giving it back to BCC. Here comes Rhett Perez, being guarded by Portillo. Perez trying to get in the lane, kicks it back out to Nelson. Bing, underneath, in the post, gets it taken away. Taken away by Portillo, has it blocked. Ooh, getting in the lane, nice move, up in the hole. Couldn't get it to go, but Kevin Charles with a nifty little crossover there, getting into the basket, but couldn't get it to connect, but he'll go to the free throw line, Ben, for two.
Yeah, they will. It looks like the traveling could be the Achilles heel for Mass Bay. It's already their second travel in the first 5 minutes of the game, and can't keep doing that.
Well, we've seen one game, Ben, where both teams were seemingly traveling back and forth. Yeah. I think the last game you and I did together.
Very true, and that's almost when you make to wonder if the ref was just travel happy as well.
Yeah. Had traveled on the brain.
Exactly.
And both free throws are missed by Tevin Charles. Mass Bay not hitting on their free throws early.
Not at all. Only hitting about 25% right now.
Yeah, it could be an Achilles heel. Nelson looking to go baseline. Can't do it. Good defense. Gomes back from the top of the key. There he is again for three. J.G. Killer with a three that puts BCC ahead. 12-11. Cross-court pass, open, Portillo, no good. Rebounded by Gomes. Mr. Do-It-All. Offset Nelson on the wing, lays it up and in. And BCC comes out of the timeout fired. 14-11. Nelson, that pass from Gomes. And here comes the pressure, Ben. Here comes the pressure by BCC. Gonna be another travel. And that's not the ref being travel happy. Another travel. That's gonna be on Jimenez, Fox again.
Yeah.
One thing you gotta remember, Ben, you gotta put the ball to the floor before you
take a step,
before you start walking.
Well, I noticed too, Mass Bay came out very cocky out of that first time out. When they were only up by five.
I see that. They were feeling pretty good about themselves.
They were, but they've unraveled since.
Rep Perez giving BCC kind of a spark. Oh, nice explosive. Ooh, that's going to be steps.
Yeah.
It was an explosive move by Jarrell Gomes, but he knows that he did it. Went sliding across the floor like he was doing electric slide or something.
Yeah. But as long as you have 2 feet on the floor, that's the important thing, right?
BCC following the basketball here. Into the game is Kevin Desire. He'll come in for Bing. For three, Portillo. It's good. Referee raises his hands. That's a three-pointer. 14-14.
And that's the second three of the game.
Yeah. And that foul is going to be on Portillo. He's going to step out of this one. Number 20 is going to come in. Number 20, Andre Sr. Andre Sr., small forward. Andre Sr., the freshman. Go figure.
I can't promise that these. Actually, I can.
Jumper by Desire can't get it to go. Rebounded by Tevin Charles. Gets it up to Sr. Back to Charles cross court to number one. That's Anthony Swain. BCC falling back. They're in a 2-3 zone. Senior in the corner for three. Had a chance to pop it, didn't he? There's Swain. Jumper at the elbow. Got it to go. Good ball movement by Mass Bay there. Finally getting the open look. It's Iowa, another jumper. Can't get it to go. That's not a shot that Rob Delalu wants, I tell you that.
Yeah.
Kevin Desire shooting from the outside. There's a three, thought about it. Almost went in, couldn't get it to go, popped out.
Yeah.
Just a little bit of hesitation there by Senior. Looks like he's not looking to pull the trigger. And Nelson's gonna lose that one out of bounds.
There he is. I can't promise these names are accurate on the Mass Bay roster. I got it off the NJCAA.
There you go.
Anyway, I got it off their website. I just noticed it was an old roster for one, but I couldn't find a good updated roster for them. So.
Oh, great.
what we got?
I think that's it right there.
No, this is the same one that I have.
Okay.
We'll make it work.
Going back the other way. Jarrell Gomes for three. Can't get it to go. Rebounded by Bardell. Anthony Swain to the hole. Can't get it to go, but he's going to go to the line. One thing that we do know, Ben, I called the start last for both teams, and the Mass Bay responded, so.
Yeah.
Yeah, they went out. They didn't say, oh, that's not my name.
Yeah. Well, the starting five, I know we have right. It's the bench people we could be wrong on.
And that first free throw was made by Anthony Swain. Mass Bay still with the lead here. He'll miss that. Rebounded. Rebounded by Jimenez Fox, trying to sneak it in there to Anthony Swain on the cut. Oh, nice spin move. Off the glass. Can't get it to go by Mardell. Pushing it up is Perez. Taking it to the basket. Oh, wow. Nice take. The little man, Rep Perez, will step up to the line. Looking like Speedy Gonzalez over there.
Sure did. He ran right by everybody. Almost made that basket, too.
Mardell came in, and the foul is going to be on him. Good, good job by him to disrupt the shot, but uh-huh. Perez will step up to the line.
That
with 11:22 left. Nice rotation, pretty shot there. 17-15. Even though BCC has come out of their timeout in a flourish and seemingly playing better basketball, they're still down in this one by a basket.
Yeah.
Perez misses the second free throw. Here's Swain. BCC in that zone, and they break down the zone.
Made it look easy.
The pass from Charles will find Jimenez Fox underneath the basket, 19-15 now. Matt Bay playing man-to-man. Here's John Mayufrium, taking it to the hole, and that foul is going to be on the floor. Foul is going to be on Andre Sr. And Marty Baker will come in. He'll replace Josh Banks. Number one, Anthony Swain just came out of the game. And number four, Isaac Rose, a freshman, has come in. Okay, we had a three-point shot, and what did I miss?
I didn't see who sunk that, actually.
Three-point shot made by BCC, 19-18. .10:27 left to play in this one, everybody. From Bishop Colony High School in Fall River, Massachusetts. You're watching Bayhawks basketball. Inside. Ooh. The miss by going to his right. Puts up a lefty shot. Mardal misses, and now Jimenez Fox cleaned up the goods. Rez Perez getting into the lane. Can't connect. Driving to the lane, Jimenez Fox. Isaac Rose for three. No, it's only going to be a two. They say his foot was on the line. So Isaac Rosa with a two-point field goal. Here's Cotton to the lane, off the glass, and in. Alex Cotton coming up the bench, number 1-2. And now BCC with the infamous press. With their infamous half-court trap now. Oh, almost stolen by Cotton. Jimenez Fox in the lane. Bounces up. Can't get it to go. Rebounded by Armani Baker. On the other end. Jarrell Gomes pops for three. Gets it to go. His third three-point field goal in the half. Ties this game up at 23-all. The ball knocked away by Ephraim in the backcourt. Perez will come out of the game for BCC. Back in the game is number four, Josh Nelson. Here comes the trap at half court. BCC loves to do this. But there, oh my goodness. Nice pass by Jimenez Fox, finding Mardal underneath. Back the other way. Baker doesn't have the numbers, but takes it to the hole. And he'll step up to the free throw line. So 23-25-23. And I'll tell you what, Ben, Mass Bay, I mean, my goodness, they are finding holes in that BCC zone. BCC, I think, is best when they are playing man-to-man and when they are getting in transition, scoring baskets, and then going immediately into their press, and they're not doing that right now.
No, well, right now they're not able to get those turnovers and get those transition points that we're used to, so they're having to play, you know, defense, and the zone don't pay off if they're finding the holes in it.
Exactly, the zones are not rotating right, they're finding, nope. they're letting guys hang out underneath the basket.
Yep.
And that's Bay. I think there's gonna be a timeout.
Yep.
Gonna be a timeout on the court by Mass Bay. Heady play by them. So 25-24. If you just joined us, we're just getting going.
We're
8:40 left here in the first half. And what do you see out here, Ben?
Right now I see both teams playing well, both teams playing very smart, you know, considering the fact we still have 8 minutes to left to go in the half, not too many fouls compared to other games we've seen. Like I said, right now, BCC needs to work on getting that transition game going, causing turnovers, getting points in the, you know, in the transition. That's where they, it's a lot of their bread and butter in these past few games has been those transition scores. So without that, they're not going to, you know, see the same production that they're used to. But right now, they're playing pretty good defense. The only issue is that zone. You know, Mass Bay is very easily finding holes in that zone, able to get under the basket, you know, getting those cherry picker points that, you know, we haven't seen very often from other teams, but Mass Bay is able to do it.
Right, we've seen other teams totally fold when BCC remotely, you know, gets close to doing that press. We've seen other teams just kind of trip over themselves.
Exactly.
Mass Bay not doing that. Mass Bay is, they're finding the open guy when BCC puts their press on, they're finding the open guy.
Exactly.
When BCC has that zone,
they're finding the open man.
Exactly, they don't get nervous. I mean, that, you know.
That's half the battle right there.
Yeah, right. They're showing why they're 11-5 coming into this game. And with 8:40, nearly 9 minutes left to go in this first half, looks like we're going to see a lot of points out here.
Definitely. It's going to be
in
a basketball
game. Isaac Rosa. Oh, nice fake. Gets it out to Swain. Swain. Back out to Rosa.
That's going to be it.
Sure what the call is. It's going to go against Mass Bay.
Yeah.
And I believe there's a foul. I think it was a foul away from the basket.
No, I think it was it might have been a charging call. It was a
turnover.
Yeah.
Nonetheless, it's a turnover. BCC basketball. Here's Gomes being guarded by Swain. Baker at the top of the key. Mass Bay in that man-to-man. Ephraim, going baseline, going to his right, puts it up with his left off the glass and in.
Makes it look easy.
Jeremiah Ephraim, number 13, with the hoop, giving BCC the lead. BCC slow with that press now. Slow getting there, slow with the trap. And there he is, another wide open man. The pass from number 5, Tevin Charles, finds it an open, wide open, him and his box on that one. Big back in the game. Loses control of the basketball. Jimenez Charles. Tevin Charles.
Yep, double dribble.
God, he had an easy basket right there.
Yeah, he
just
did.
Totally
he
fumbled on himself.
Yeah, he did.
And he'll lose control of the basketball. BCC gets it back.
Yeah.
7:25 to play.
Impressive to see how Fox just finds his way right under that basket
every time.
It's amazing.
Oh, Ephraim finding a cutting Jarrell Gomes there. Nice play by Ephraim.
Made it look easy on that one.
28-27, both teams trading scores. Here's him in his box. To Mardell in the corner. Mardell splits defenders. Back out to Rosa. Nice crisp passing. Isaac Rosa for three. Can't get it to go. Tipped up, rebounded by Gomes. Quickly out to Ephraim. Ephraim on the wing. Pulls up from the elbow. Jump shot. No good. Swain pushing it. Back out. Isaac Rosa cross court. Tevin Charles in the lane. Loses control of it, and it's going to be BCC basketball.
Last possession BCC had Ephraim with the ball. They had 3-2. Why Nelson didn't fight for that rebound surprised me. They had the numbers.
Yeah. All right, so 28-27, 6:20 left here in the first half. Rob Del Lue calling out the play. It's Providence. One of my favorite towns. Providence, Rhode Island just lost a soldier.
Yeah, they did.
This week.
Yeah.
Mr. Vincent
Buddy Cianci.
Mr. Buddy Cianci.
Yeah.
You know, that guy gets a lot of...
Flack, but he did a lot of good
for
that
flack,
city
but he
as
did
well.
A lot of good for that city. He built that city from the ground up, so.
That he did.
Our condolences go out to his family and, you know... Ephraim misses that free throw.
Yeah.
The front end of a 1-on-1.
goodness. Oh my goodness, a slam.
What a dunk.
Nice pass by Trevor Charles underneath to find Mardell. And Trevor Charles almost lost his pivot foot there. Good job. Oh my goodness, nice pass to Bing.
Nice.
Not quite the same finish, but anyway, it's a finish.
But 2 points is 2 points, no matter how pretty they look.
Yeah, nice pass by Gomes to find Bing underneath, and both teams.
Yeah.
Trading scores.
Yeah.
Trading the lead. We've had a few. We've had three or four lead changes here in the last couple minutes.
Now we have.
Underneath. Kicking it back out. Swain. Lefty three. No good. Nice rebound. Nice rebound by Baker. I love the way he plays the game.
Yeah.
Alta Gomes on the wing. 3-point shot. It's good. J.G. Killer.
Man is shooting from 100%.
Jarrell Gomes.
Shooting 100% from behind the line.
Yeah, so that's his 4 3-pointer of the first half, Ben. He's
that it is.
Red hot from out there.
He just gave his team a 4-point lead with 5:08 left to go in this game.
Yeah, we've seen both teams trading leads here in the last few minutes, and that 3-pointer right there ends that 33-29. And as we mentioned before, Ben, BCC this last month is just playing better, more inspired basketball, better teamwork. Playing together better as a team.
It's amazing what a little break, what a difference a little break made.
That's true. Rosa finds Kevin Charles, cross court to Swain, back underneath to the big man. Margell, he's so strong underneath, can't get it to go though. Good defense by Jason Bing.
And I'm noticing now BCC's kind of patched up those holes in the zone they had before.
A little bit. But that one almost knocked away. BCC gets it back. Ephraim underneath to Bing. Boy, he's strong. Where did Rob Del Lu find this guy? Jason Bing to center.
Yep, 6 points in this first half so far.
Yes, sir. Jason Bing, the sophomore center from Brockton, Massachusetts. God, the crisp passing. You can't say enough about it. But the foul is going to be, it's going to stay right here. Wow. You can't say enough about the crisp passing, the precision, crisp passing by Mass Bay. It really
Definitely.
Is. It really is a story here in the first half. Nice give and go there from Mr. Mardell, Niamh Gray Mardell, back to Fox. I mean, those two guys play well together.
Rob Del Lu a little frustrated right now after that foul.
And you can't blame him, but his team does have the lead.
Exactly.
That free throw was made, so the 3-point play the old fashioned way.
Exactly.
35-32. Mass Bay continues to play in that man to man. Jarrell Gomes, step back three. He loves it. Oh, my goodness. Somebody is red hot.
Yes,
J.G. Killer. Jarrell Gomes is fifth three, 38-32. 15 points on just threes alone by Jarrell Gomes. Show why I called him all nation, all world.
Yep, 19 points in the game so far.
Go on baseline. The foul looks like it's going to be on number 30, Jason Bing, the big man.
Yep.
Both teams in the bonus now.
Yep.
Both teams with 17 fouls, so we will have at least one and ones.
Yep.
The rest of the way.
Yep. Charles in to shoot one and one. Bing's going to step out for a bit, and Kevin Zier's going to come in.
I love how deep their bench is now. Because
it's amazing.
You know, instead of Kevin Desire getting more minutes, you got him coming up the bench now. And Jason Bing has shown that he can man the post, and he's got some good post moves down there.
Yep.
You know, you give him little spells here and there. You got Kevin Desire coming up the bench, Alex Cotton,
yep.
A couple big guys there, and you know, away you go. Gives this team an added dimension. Before you just seen a lot of fast guys, a lot of wing players, you know, but between Jason Bing and Kevin Desire and Jarrell Gomes, you've got guys that can go and crash the boards. All right, we're having a little malfunction here. A little shot clock malfunction that we've seen before.
Shot clock malfunction, we'll try it again.
Better than a wardrobe malfunction.
Hey, it all depends what
AKA
you watch.
AKA Janet Jackson.
Yeah.
What Super Bowl was that? I think that was. I want to say that was Patriots Carolina.
No, I think it was actually earlier than that. I want to say that was like a 2002 Super Bowl.
No, it was definitely Patriots.
No, I don't think so. I think it might have been after the.
We'll look it up at the half. Going baseline. Yes, strong move. Gomes. He cannot be stopped now. Going to the whole baseline.
21 points this first half.
BCC putting up a standard 40. Oh. That ball's knocked away by Gomes. Desire on the floor to get the ball. On his knees.
Jump ball, but it's still going to be BCC basketball.
It is going to be BCC basketball.
Possession arrow in their favor.
Great hustle. On the court right now for BCC, number 12, Alex Totten is taking up the ball. With Perez, Kevin Desire, number 23. Jarrell Gomes, number 1. And number 4, Joshua Nelson. Here's Nelson. Nelson's going to stop and pop it. Ooh, that rolls out. And I think Alex Totten got the rebound, but he stepped on the line there.
Actually, they're calling a push on him. And then you're going to go to the line to shoot 1-1.
Yes, sir. Any foul from here on out through the first half, it's going to be shots.
That it is.
That's the 18th foul by BCC. And going to the line is Mr. Jimenez Fox. Cameron Jimenez Fox.
Yeah.
Mass Bay really screwing me up here with the names.
Yes.
Too long.
Yes,
you get the three name thing. You got Cameron Jimenez Fox at the line.
Yeah.
But the guys with the longest names have made the biggest impact for Mass Bay. Jimenez Fox and Ziev Gray Madal. Yeah. Down the other end, that ball is tipped. And they can't connect on that long pass there, so it's going to be Mass Bay basketball.
Quick transition, quick turnover.
BCC looking to trap. The thing is, Mass Bay is so fast. Swing. That ball knocked away by BCC. Getting hot in here, man.
Yeah, it is. It's hot since we walked in the door.
Getting hot. I'm drinking this hot coffee.
Yeah, I know. You should have brought ice, my friend.
That hot action here.
Yeah.
Yeah, I should have got that. Yeah, you're right. Exactly. I should have got iced coffee.
I didn't see you run out this water
13
shot.
On the shot clock. Kevin Charles back out to Swain. Might have to pop that one. Oh, nice. We're coming off the screen there. On the shot clock, I have to shoot it. I don't know what they were doing.
No, I have no idea. They were not watching the shot clock, that's for sure.
You gotta shoot it.
So everybody but the man who had the ball was watching the shot clock, because the rest of the team's looking at him like, what were you thinking?
Just shoot it, man. Don't worry about it. You gotta put that up.
Yeah.
Here comes Red Perez. Bay bench into it. Shanton defense. For three, Perez, it looks good. Oh, no, it doesn't connect on it.
Looks so good from him.
It did look good from this vantage point. Nice rotation. Coming back is Mass Bay. On the wing, in the lane, Tevin Charles. Strong move to the basket. Doesn't get it to go, but he will step to the line for two.
Call the foul on Kevin Desire.
The foul's going to be on Kevin Desire. BCC started off slow. Mass Bay was in the lead for most of this first half, Ben, but you know, with a minute 50 here.
BCC holding on to a five point lead
now. As Tevin Charles sinks that one.
Now go to the line for one more.
Yeah, BCC has 19 fouls, so one more, and everything's going to be two shots.
Two shots, yeah. Now they got to be careful. This last
second free throw
50.
Miss, rebound grab by Ephraim. Finding Desire. Perez, jump shot. Can't get it to go. Oh, rebounded by the big man, Mardal. Mardal going to the lane. Stops. He's going to get bumped. Jeremiah Ephraim trying to beat him to the point. Bumped him. And Gray Ziev, Gray Mardal is going to step up to the line.
Yes, he is.
So that foul, number
10.
Yep, and
he will shoot two now.
He will shoot two. That was on the shot anyway.
No, they said it was way before the shot. He was dry. He wasn't in the act of shooting when they called the foul.
Okay.
That's why it's the 10th foul and he's gonna shoot two. Matt, help you up again.
Appreciate it. First free throw missed by Mardell. Kevin Desire will come out.
Banks will come in.
Josh Banks will come in, number two. Josh Banks out there with Jarrell Gomes across the way there. Josh Nelson, number four. Number three, Rev Perez. And number 13, Jeremiah Ephraim.
Looks like Jimenez Fox is going to step out for a second. He cut himself, I think.
So we have a little blood in the court. It looks like Jimenez Fox is going to get patched up by the trainer here.
Right.
A little stop action, 40-35. So Ben, as we were saying before, BCC comes on a little bit of a hot streak. Winners of their last five, eight of their last 10. Mm-hmm. And Mr. Jarrell Gomes has been a huge reason. 5 3-pointers here in the first half. He's taken over this first half. It seems like he's unstoppable right now. He's 10th in the nation in points per game, averaging nearly 23 points per game, and he's second in Region 21. I mean, he's a big reason why the Bayhawks are where they're at right now. Both teams have similar records. The Bayhawks are battling for second place, actually, with Mass Bay Community College here in Region 21. So this game is for, has big, major tournament implications here.
Definitely.
As both teams battle for one of the top two spots here in, Region 21. So this is a big game between, two similar teams, two athletic teams, two teams that like to get up and down the court. Very well matched. BCC, it seems like most games, BCC is the more athletic team, the more faster team. Today, BCC has never seen nothing like it. The Mass Bay is beating them down the court, beating them to the spot.
Yeah.
I mean, they're able to break the press because with their athleticism and the way that they pass the ball, they got the eye. They're finding open guys. They're anticipating. They're anticipating BCC's press and where they're going to be.
They're beating them to the spot sometimes. We saw numerous times Cameron Jimenez Fox getting under the basket just waiting there for a shot. And, easy as pie, he gets out there and he's able to grab it. He's able to grab easy buckets repeatedly.
And how many times have we seen Jimenez Fox down low, underneath, wide open, or Ziev Gray Mardell underneath, wide open? We've seen both these guys kind of working and playing off each other a little bit. So those two guys have tremendous chemistry.
Definitely.
Together, so. But nonetheless, with all that being said, now BCC has a 40-35 lead here with a minute and 32 left. So,
seeing this right now, what we're looking at is kind of tough because it can go in two different directions. You had this long pause as they clean up from the injury, but does that play well into giving the team a break, or does that play not so well into the team getting kind of almost lackadaisical now because they're not in that game time mentality? You know what I mean?
Right.
You'll lose that fire. We'll see what happens from here.
Yeah, that can happen, but nonetheless, it's going to be halftime pretty soon, so.
Yeah, so.
We'll see what happens. Ziev Mardell steps up to the line.
Yeah.
As they get that blood situation taken care of.
Yeah.
Everybody, you're watching, if you're watching Channel 95 in your dial, FR Media, Bayhawks basketball. And that second free throw was made. It's 40-36. You're watching Bayhawks basketball from Bishop Conley. As we have a little discussion here on the court.
Yep.
Coach Rob Del Lugue got his first, as the first Bristol head coach to reach 100 wins. He reached that goal on December 10th. Bayhawks also holding teams to just 78.1 points per game.
Yep.
Here's Rev Perez. To Josh Banks at the top of the key, being doubled. Nelson, cross court pass, way out of bounds. Yeah. Way over the head of Mr. Rev Perez.
Yes, thought Ray was a little taller than that.
Yeah, exactly.
Maybe he was mistaken.
Maybe if he was on a couple step ladders.
Yep, or he was standing on the at least the first row of seats.
Exactly.
Would have had that, no problem.
Would have been perfect. And there we go. That's what I'm talking about. Anticipating the trap. Before that trap gets to them, they're releasing that basketball. Again. BCC again with great defense. Shot clock winding down. Kevin Charles in the lane. Him and his block, strong move. Little jump hook in the lane. And Rob Delanue hates it. 40-38. Perez being guarded by Isaac Rosa. All up in his shorts. Jones feeling it. Kicks it back out. Nelson for three. No good. Rebounded by Swain.
Nelson just can't find the spot from three.
Mass Bay can hold for the last shot here. 25 on the shot clock. It's a three-second difference. Yeah. Cross court to Isaac Rosa. BCC in a 2-3 zone. Going baseline. Oh my goodness. Blowing right by the defender. Blowing right by Banks and an easy basket. Easy basket by Kevin Charles. Shot clock turned off. 5 on the game clock. Gomes holding for the last shot. Throws it out of bounds at the buzzer. Rob Delanue doesn't like it, and it's tied 40-40. That's the end of the first half. Wow. What an end there.
Yeah.
What a turn of events. BCC, we were talking, Ben, BCC had the lead 40-34. You talked about that little break there.
Yeah.
And
made a big difference.
As inconsequential as that seems, you were kind of right that may have a little bit of effect on them. Now, I'm not sure if it's really, you know, coincidental or whatever, but right after that, you know, Mass Bay storms right back, 6-0 run to tie this game at 40-40. And I'm not sure what Mr. Banks was doing there on the baseline. He let Tevin Charles blow by him.
Oh, yeah, he just let him walk right by him.
Just put his hands up.
Yeah.
You know, you're not in foul trouble. You know, you're a bench player. Mm-hmm. And
as a matter of fact, at the buzzer, you could hear Gomes yell, "Hey, coach, they don't want to play," after that errant pass out of bounds.
Exactly. That was a play that that really sliced the cake there. So
that it was.
Yeah. So 40-40 at the half. Mr. Jarrell Gomes was the big factor there for BCC.
Definitely 21 points in the first half.
Yes, sir. So anyway, so 40-40 with our Bishop Conley High School. I'm David Cardoza on the call with Mr. Benjamin Andrews. We're going to take this break here at halftime, and we'll be right back after this. Welcome back, everybody. Look how quick we just came back. It's magic, huh? Television magic. I'm David Cardoza, and I'm along here with my colleague, Mr. Benjamin Barabini Andrews, as we're here at Bristol. I mean, not Bristol, but Bishop Conley High School, right next to Bristol Community College. The halftime score here between your Bristol Community College Bayhawks and Mass Bay. Mass Bay Community College, 40-40. So Ben, first half, both teams kind of went on a run there.
They did.
Both teams exhibiting their athleticism. Yeah. And we had a lot of lead changes too there for a good 5-minute period. So this has been a very competitive basketball game. Both teams come in vying for that number 2 spot in Region 21 as BCC comes in here riding the hot streak. Winning 5 games in a row, 8 of their last 10. They're 11-6. They're 9-4 in the conference. And Mass Bay 11-5. They're also 9-4 in Region 21. So this game, the winner of this game will have that number 2 slot all to themselves. What did you see in the first half? Actually, let's talk about the scoring. The scoring for both teams here.
Yep.
Let's talk about the top scorers here.
Top scorers, you got Jarrell Gomes, without a doubt, top scorer for BCC, shooting 100% from behind the line for the game, trained five three-pointers in the first half, peppered in a couple twos as well. Right behind him, a distance behind him was Jason Bing with 6 points, and then you had Jeremiah Ephraim, Alex Cotton, and Nelson all with basically 5 points. Nelson had 4. As for Mass Bay, Cameron Jimenez Fox led scoring with 13 points, and then Ziu Graymar and Mandel. He had 8 points, and then Brandon Portillo had 6, and Tevin Charles had 7. So they kind of all worked together and peppered their points around. But as you can see, it's not hard to find the leading scorer for BCC in this first half.
Well, Darrell Gohan was very instrumental in that first half for BCC. He was the, he was a scoring machine that first half. You know, when he starts getting going from the outside, I mean, he's so dangerous on the drive as it is, but when he starts popping those outside shots, you better respect it, and he'll blow by you in an instant. So, BCC, averaging 84.4 points per game. They're almost halfway there. So as this second half gets underway, we welcome you all back to Bishop Conley High School, the home of your Bristol Community College Bayhawks, as Mass Bay will open up with the basketball.
They will.
Tevin Charles going baseline. Strong move up high off the glass. Doesn't get it to go, but he'll step up to the line for shots. I'm waiting for that first cheer from our BCC faithful out there.
I know.
One cheer. Can we get a cheer out there?
I look more like the BCC confused than the faithful, but I appreciate them just the same.
Exactly. That first free throw trickles off the front of the rim and lands in for Tevin Charles.
Yes, it does.
You're watching us. You're watching Bayhawks basketball here on FR Media, Channel 95, and your Comcast dial here in the local area. Here's Jeremiah Ephraim with the basketball. 42-40 lead. Mass Bay leads. Going underneath. Gomes to a cutting. Baker gets it blocked. That one was blocked by Jimenez Fox. Nice block there. Going back Mass Bay's way. Jimenez. That's a long three. No good. It rolls out. Portillo misses. Nelson pushing the basketball. Loses control of it. Lazy pass across the way to Ephraim. Driving to his left. It's going to be a foul on Anthony Swain. I'm expecting a barn burner here in the second half, Ben. We've been witnesses to a couple blowouts last couple games. BCC has really blown teams out. This one looks to go to the wire.
Exactly. I think it will.
Nice crossover. Dumps it off to Bing. Underneath, controls himself. Can't get it to go. Baker cleans up. Armani Baker puts it up and in. We're tied at 42.
He puts his first two points of the game on the board.
And there it is, breaking that press. They had another one there, Ben.
Yeah.
Mass Bay been so good at really breaking up BCC's press, but they lose that one out of bounds. Here comes Jeremiah Ethan.
And that's what you need to see happen. Once BCC starts getting these turnovers, they'll be able to open it up on them.
Bing loses his footing, loses control of the basketball. Gomes picks it up for three, can't get it to go. And there's a miss, Ben. And that basketball is going to go back Mass Bay's way.
Yes, and actually Bing held pretty good control for a man falling down to get the pass and pass it over to Gomes as he was going down. It's actually pretty impressive.
Almost losing control of that one. Ooh, stepping up. Jumper, no good. That's going to be off Mass Bay.
Yep.
That's going to be off Anthony Swain. Jeremiah Ephraim bringing the ball up court for BCC, being guarded by Swain. Here's Josh Nelson. Baker cutting to the hole. Terrell Gomes, strong move,
wow,
up and in.
What a drive by Gomes on that play, just blowing right through him.
That's what I talked about. You have to respect the outside shot, then he'll just blow right by you.
Exactly.
Going to be a foul there. It's going to be an Armani Baker.
Yep.
I don't know about you, Ben, but I'm not seeing the electricity from the Bayhawks on the defensive end. I'm really not seeing that
tenacity like we've been used to seeing. I'm not seeing a spirited defense right now. They're really, really slow getting to the ball, really slow kind of getting to their spot. We're not seeing the turnovers that they usually create.
Yeah.
And it just doesn't seem as tenacious as we are usually seeing.
Exactly.
And the communication doesn't seem to be there. You got to communicate on defense. Going to be a timeout on the floor, 17-23 to play, 44-42. The home team has the lead. So Ben, we talked about the Bayhawks, and when they're at their best, they're really, really playing tenacious, spirited defense. They're getting in the passing lanes and creating a lot of turnovers.
Yep.
And it just seems like they're just not feeling it on defense right now.
They really seem kind of lazy out there.
And I think that's a
You can see the
frustration of Rob Del Lue.
Mm-hmm.
You know, Jeremiah Ephraim, a couple times down the court there, he had a chance to get a loose basketball there, but didn't seem to want to go and get after it.
No. You can't, you know. It's not magic that lights that spark. You know, they need a.
Yeah, a lot riding on this game. You're trying to get up there, one of the top two spots in Region 21.
Exactly.
As the season winds down here, the last game of the season is next Tuesday, and then we're getting ready for tournament time. So this is the time of the year where you're going to be playing your best basketball, and BCC's been doing that, but tonight, trying to fight through what they're fighting through.
Exactly.
Him and his Fox. We'll nail that one. A lot of long way to go on this one.
Yeah. See if this little injury on that foul is going to hinder him at all.
Him and his Fox hits both free throws. Something we haven't seen them do that much today.
Nope.
Free throw shooting has been a tough time for Mass Bay. What's Mass Bay's nickname over here?
I don't even know.
We've been calling it Mass Bay.
Yeah, exactly. But it rolls off the tongue well. Sorry for
our ignorance. Ignorance is bliss here on the FR Media. Drive it to the hole. Reverse lay-in. Boy, J.G. Gomes having a game.
Coming out shooting once again.
Yes, taking it to the hole. I like to see Jarrell Gomes when he's going to the hole. 46-24 BCC. Here's that press.
Nelson just running back and forth across the court.
But it looks like he's just dragging.
Yeah.
10 on the shot clock. Fox spins it a lane, fade away, can't get it to go. Nice rebound by Gomes, gets it to the outlet man. Ephraim trying to get in the lane. And the foul is going to be on Brian Portillo.
Yep.
Brandon Portillo, I'm sorry.
Oh, no, actually it's on Anthony Swain, I think.
I thought they just said 1-0, but maybe it was just one. It is, you're right, Ben, I'm sorry. You are correct, sir.
Yes, I saw him protesting, so I had a feeling.
Baker can't get it to go.
And they got
Mass Bay got the number. Swain puts it up off the glass. Can't get it to go. Rebounded by Portillo there to clean it up. No one there to box out for BCC.
Nope. Nobody even tried to swat that down.
Nelson on the other end. Knocked away by Portillo. It's going to be out of bounds off Portillo.
It's great when everybody under the basket's taller than him, but doesn't try and stop him from taking the shot.
Here's Gomes. Gomes on the wing. 12 on the shot clock. Nice bounce pass to a cutting Baker. Oh, what a hell. That would have been a hell of a play. But couldn't get it to go. Nice find by Gomes on that. Nice bounce pass underneath from Portillo, but Martell couldn't connect. Pushing it so fast as Nelson. And gets it off the glass. I don't know how he got that off. I don't know how he got that one off the glass. But it goes up and in.
What a circus shot.
No one's moving. No one's moving for BCC. Up off the glass is Tevin Charles. Gomes on the other end. Swoop into the hoop with the left hand. Flop it to the ground. No foul call there. Shot clock winding down, 17 on the shot clock. Oh, what a, ooh, through the lane. How did he get there?
Afro slipped out of bottom.
That ball slipped out of his hands, almost went in. Nelson on the other end, can't get it to go. Cotton, strong move, can't get it to go. Block by, nice block by Fox.
Yeah, it's getting a little Tasmanian devilish out there, going back and forth, my head spinning.
I know.
48-48. Both teams flying back up and down the court.
Yeah.
Anthony Swain will step up to the line. He got fouled. And Swain gets that one to roll in. And we'll give Mass Bay Community College the lead. And Anthony Swain calmly sinks both free throws there, giving his team a 2-point lead. Jeremiah Ephraim to his right, dumps it up to Cotton. Cotton loses it. And they're going to call a foul. Looks like it's going to be.
Coach Delalu wasn't very happy with that no call on that on that play where Gerald Gomes went flying to the ground. He was giving the ref a little bit of his mind about it.
Yeah, a lot of frustration out here.
Oh, yeah.
Cotton misses the first free throw. So that foul is on number 23, Cameron Jimenez Fox. His first of the game. Cotton misses both free throws. Oh, open look. Swain underneath. Oh, nice block and rebound by Cotton. Nice defensive play. Gomes behind his back, loses control of it. Loose ball. Swain up, puts it up off the glass and in.
Swain picking up control of that ball at the last second. I thought he was gonna.
Ephraim on the other end. Rob Delu's gonna call a timeout, and just like that, Ben, Mass Bay is taking the lead, 52-48. Wow, what a whirlwind.
I know.
What a whirlwind of emotions we're going through right now. This one is. This one is what? Haywire and helter skelter for sure.
Definitely. It's just been a weird back and forth battle. BCC seems like they're almost starting to unravel a little bit here, and you're hoping they're going to hold it together. But I mean, it's interesting to see. It's just like they can't get their
mojo going, and on defense, it just seems like they're not getting to the loose balls.
No, they're just kind of standing still on defense, and then offense, they're just not finishing. They're not going strong, you know. So it's interesting to see how the rest of this half's going to play out.
And the other thing, Ben. Jarrell Gomes has really only been, he's been the only guy that has really stepped up offensively for this team.
He's been the only offense.
He's been the only offense. He's been everything.
Exactly.
Like you said, Jason Bing was a second lead scorer in the first half with 6 points, but no one else has really been able to find their own shot or been able to create any more offense. Or,
you know, most games usually see Nelson and Gomes kind of share the responsibility through the game. But
right. I think it's time for Josh Nelson to step up. You know, we usually see him, you know, from three-point range. He's unable to get those shots right now. Their offense is really looking kind of shaky. We talked about how much better their offense got the last several games with them sharing the basketball, with them being unselfish. Mm-hmm. But in this game,
they're starting to revert to that
rebound. They're going back to isolation, but they're going back to Jarrell Gomes being the only scorer for them.
Yep.
And when that happens, you know, they struggle. But they're lucky that Jarrell Gomes is going off.
Exactly.
And that's the only reason they're in this basketball game right now. So 52-48. Bishop Conley High School.
Take away any portion of his points in this game, they're losing badly.
I mean, they're losing badly right now. So, I mean, other guys need to step their game up, to say the least.
Can't be a one-man game.
No, I like the way Mass Bay playing. Good team basketball right now. They're really moving the basketball. And I think BCC getting kind of tired because the way that they're not able to do what they do. Off the glass, Jimenez on the drive, out of the timeout, 54-48. Mass Bay with a 6-point lead. And Nelson, that's a three that he usually pulls. There's a three. Thought about it too long. Cotton gets it to a cutting Baker. Can't get it to go. BCC, you can just tell the body language. Yeah, yep. That's a shot that we've seen Josh Nelson just take.
Oh, yeah. Nate, easily.
Remember we talked about that hesitation three?
Yep.
He hesitated too long there.
Definitely. Psyched himself out on it.
BCC playing good defense, though. Five on the shot clock. Turnaround jumper, Tevin Charles up, can't get it to go.
Oh, nice.
Gomes. Off to Baker on the wing. Nelson has to step up. Baseline jumper, no good.
Oh, nice.
Rebounded by Mondal.
Poor guy can't buy a shot today.
Yeah, he looks very hesitant out there, man.
Yep.
Not on that one, but
nope.
You can tell he's not confident right now.
Not at all.
Trapped in the corner. Cross-court pass, too many guys left wide open. Charles getting into the lane, splits the defense, off the glass, drops it home.
That's Bay making it look easy now with an 8-point lead.
A lot of open guys.
Oh yeah, defense is not reacting at all.
Jarrell Gomes on the wing, looking to drive, jump step, gets it underneath, can't get it to go, blocked by Mardell, nice defensive play. God, he's a beast underneath. But Mass Bay will give it right back to BCC. So. Armani Baker, Alex Kahn, Jeremiah Ephraim will step out. Rev Perez, who actually gave BCC a boost in the first half, and if you remember, when he came in, BCC's offense looked a lot better. Gomes for three. He's gone cold. Rebound swing. Charles, that ball's gonna be kickball. Gomes with the kick. So again, Rev Perez is in. Kevin Desire, and back in there is Jason Bing. So Coach Rob Del Lugo and Big here. He's got Jarrell Gomes out there with Jason Bing and Kevin Desire. Oh, put up by Partillo. That was a Britkowski.
Yeah,
rebounded by Desire to Perez, up to Nelson on the wing. Steps.
And BCC earns their travel this time. Kind of looks like they can get a chance to battle back. They hand it right back.
Coach Bill Rayner getting fired up, stomping the little stomp over there. Coach Rayner from Mass Bay barking out instructions to his team.
Yeah.
Step. Oh, gonna be a push off. Looks like the push off is gonna be on number 10.
Nope, number 23.
That's why you're
Cameron
here, Ben. That's why you're here, Ben. That's why they pay you the big bucks.
I know. So I'm still part of the call team.
Okay, so 11 minutes, approaching 11 minutes to play in this one.
Yep.
Time for BCC to get it going.
Definitely, they got plenty
Jason
of time.
Jason Bing on the post. They don't get it to him, and then they throw it out of bounds. BCC all out of sorts, making a lot of errant passes in this one, Ben.
I know. Once again, thinking Ray Perez is much taller than he is.
That's true. That's the second or third time we've seen that today.
I know. I mean, he's a little man. You can't throw it. Can't throw it at your eye level.
Perez seems to be the only one hustling to the basketball. And that one goes out of bounds. So luckily, BCC gets the ball back. Nelson and Perez in the backcourt for BCC. Jeremiah Ephraim looking to go to the basket. Can't get it to go.
That's a shooting
Another guy that we've seen step up here in the last few games, Ben, has been this guy, Jeremiah Ephraim. He's been
definitely.
He's been a vital card for them offensively as a team, and you know, he needs to get it going.
Yeah, he's a great ball handler too.
Definitely is. This is the first free throw.
Hopefully he can grab the second one.
Despite their shooting woes, I mean, BCC.
Only down by eight.
We know that they can get points quickly when
This is their game to lose right now, folks.
Jeremiah Ephraim gets the second one to roll.
That's his first points of the second half.
Perez, so fast. You gotta like his hustle.
Yep.
Oh, that ball loose. God. I don't know how Mass Bay.
That's gonna stay here?
It's gonna stay right here.
Oh, no, I lied.
I don't know how Mass Bay, I'm not sure how they lost that. No, it's gonna go BCC.
Yep. I thought the jump ball was gonna be in BCC favor, but I think Mass Bay got the ball at the beginning of the second half, so BCC ball.
So loose, Ben. Perez. Perez loses control of that one. Loose ball. Coming away with it is Gray Mardell. Looked like, ooh, did he take a step there? That was close. In the corner, three-point shot, Charles. Can't get it to go, but the rebound falls in Fox's hands and puts it up and in. Wow.
He's already got 6 points in this second half.
Sure it does. Going back the other way. Bing.
No shot, gonna give him the push.
Gonna be a push.
Holmes is coming back in after a short break.
That foul is going to be the second one. That's going to be on Gray Mardell. Taking the ball underneath his own basket is Mr. Joshua Nelson. Way out to Ephraim. BCC finds themselves down by 9. Ephraim looking to drive in the corner. Perez thought about it. Pulls up for the jumper. No good. It's an air ball. Jeez Louise. That's not his shot. That's not his shot. Shooting that outside shot is not a high percentage shot for him.
Nope.
Wow. BCC has a chance to get turnovers. They can't get them.
I know.
Andre Sr. gets it down underneath. And there's a steal.
Oh,
and they give it right back. Swank. Portillo for 3. No good. Nelson on the wing. Lost control of it, but...
Like,
looks like he's going to go to the line. Nelson misses the first free throw, but he hits the second one.
And he does.
Back down by 8, within striking distance. A lot of time left in this one.
Yeah.
You know, BCC keeps getting deflections. There's loose balls out there to be had, but it seems like Mass Bay has just been getting the ball up there.
Yeah, they're just not finishing. They're not finishing on their opportunities. They get good opportunities, and they blow them.
But it seems like, you know, the... Sometimes there's balls out there to be had, but it seems like, you know.
They're not finishing like they usually do.
Yeah, Mass Bay is getting to the 50-50 balls.
Yeah, they are.
And sometimes the ball is just bouncing right back in their hands. It's just like, just lucky.
That's tough because you look at BCC, they got the deeper bench of the two teams. They can play, they can make scoring opportunities, they can score. We've seen them do it before and, you know, they're not converting tonight like they usually do.
That's for sure. And like you said, BCC does have the deeper bench. I mean, you got 12, 13 guys on this roster, you know. And, a lot of different guys here because there's a few guys, you know, we won't mention any names here, but we've got a few guys that are, academically ineligible.
Yep.
You know, and, this is a different roster. In the first couple months of the season, we didn't see guys like Jason Bing. You know, he came out of nowhere.
Yep.
A guy like Rev Perez, he's come out of nowhere. And these guys have really come out and been integral parts in helping this team, you know, go on this little run. You know, they've gotten some height out of nowhere.
Oh, definitely. And that has definitely made a difference in some of the games. So hopefully it can make a difference in this game and they can come back.
That's for sure. I mean, you have guys like, another guy like number 21 who we haven't seen here tonight, Mel Miller. He's a center. He's a sophomore at Providence, Rhode Island. He's another big guy. You know, so they've gotten some height.
Definitely.
You know, they kind of changed the makeup of their team.
Yes, they have.
You know, we don't get a bunch of guys out here gunning threes anymore.
Nope.
You know, they found an inside game.
Yeah, exactly. We got guys can play down low.
Yeah. Oh, taking it to the hole off the inbound. Can't get it to go. Rebound by Bing. See, he's out there to be an enforcer.
Exactly, and that's what he needs to do.
Oh, Gomes. Great. Gomes about to break some ankles.
That was cool.
Someone else has to step up offensively.
Yep.
Is it this guy? Fade away from the elbow. Can't get it to go. Looks like there might have been a foul here, but nothing doing. No call from the ref. Cross-court pass. That cross-court pass always open. For three, Portillo gets it to go. Three ball is good. Mass Bay opens up a double figures lead here. Jeremiah Ephraim on the drive. Oh, off the glass and in. Maybe that could give him a spark then.
We will see.
Nice drive by Ephraim. Gets it up off the glass. We get a foul way before.
Yep.
And it's going to be on number 14.
Yeah, Monty Baker.
It's going to be on Monty Baker. Getting underneath. Mardaw taking it on Bing. He's going to get to the free throw line. The foul's going to be on Jason Bing.
Nope, actually it was on Gomes.
My goodness. I tell you, that's why you're here, Ben.
Yeah. Deciphering the ref code.
So we got Gomes bringing it. That's going to be four. Looks like it's four. If our scoreboard is correct.
Yeah, fourth foul of the game. Yeah. Both teams are now in the bonus.
So look like we haven't seen Steven Gonzalez over here.
Yeah, we haven't seen him in a while.
We haven't seen him, you know, we've seen him in spurts. We haven't seen him that much this game, for sure.
Yeah, we haven't seen him at all this game.
Exactly.
First Hell. Time in, we'll see if we can bring some new life.
Hell, he's not even on the roster.
No.
This gym is way too quiet.
I know.
This team is way too quiet. On that free throw, you can hear a pin drop. Are we at Augusta National at the Masters?
Yeah, I was going to say it.
Like Nelson had an open three there. He's not looking to pop it.
Now
Nelson
he is.
For three. There it is. Got
yeah,
it. For three.
He's got it.
Maybe that could get him going, for Christ's sake. Three-point shot.
Oh, Sutton to get his groove back.
Cuts it to within seven. A lot of time. A shot like that could get a team its groove back, like you said, Ben. Andre Senior for three, no good.
Nice.
Rebounded by Gomes. To the hole, puts it up and in. Good job by Gomes to slow it down, gain his composure, and put that one calmly off the glass for the lay-in. And just like that, it's a five-point lead.
Yeah.
It was just an 11-point lead a couple minutes ago.
Exactly. I think somebody dropped those paddles and shot them back to
10
life.
On the shot clock, big possession here. Oh, but Fox again. Fox finding his way into the zone, into the lane. Ephraim dumps it up to Bing, up the glass, gets it to go.
Ooh, he gets it to go.
Bing gets it to go.
And one.
Number 3-0.
Yeah. Big man Jason Bing is going to the line to shoot one more.
And I tell you what, having him with the lineup is such a, he's just a presence.
I know.
You know, he can make those little bunnies, you know, you feed it to him off a drive or something, or he gets it
on the rebound, like right. This play you just saw. I mean,
he's actually a good functional big man. It's something that this team hasn't seen. He misses the three-point play shot there, but. Guys are wide open.
I know.
There's a three-point shot. No good. No good by Portillo. Mass Bay going to come up with it. Ends up back in Portillo's hands. Splits the defense. on the wing. Andre Sr. down low to Mardal. Goes to his left. Can't get it to go. Stays with it. Can't get it to go. Rebound by Fox. Gets it to go. And he's being hugged by his teammate.
Boy, does this guy just find a way. Wow.
Bing will come out. Bing will come out for BCC. Oh, time. Now time we see some life. See some life out of that crowd. It doesn't matter. Fox with the free throw, but still good to see some life out of that crowd.
He's already got 11 points in the second half.
Baker goes baseline. He loves baseline. Can't get it to go. Stays with it. Puts it up. Good and hustle there by Baker. Claps his hands. He's going to go to the line.
Yeah. They can draw those fouls. That's going to be a big difference maker, you know?
I tell you what, if somehow BCC, you're right. If they can sink these free throws, because now Mass Bay has nine.
Exactly.
They had 19 fouls there on the prefaces of being the double bonus. BCC's right there. And Baker hits their first free throw.
It's the second one. They're back to it.
Both teams are in the bonus. But there's a lot of time left to play. We're going to see a lot of free throws. So.
Yeah, we are.
Baker hits two big free throws there, 67 to 62. They know how to split the defense. They know how to move that basketball. Down low, strong move to the hole. Can't get it to go though.
Baker gets the rebound.
He's going to his right and shooting with his left. Going to the hole. Oh, what a block by Martell.
But they're going to turn it over, and it's going to be BCC basketball still.
You're right, Ben. It's going to stay right here. Mardell blocked that, but it went out of bounds.
Well, no, Portillo got the ball back, but he stepped out of bounds.
He stepped out of bounds with it. So BCC will get the ball underneath their own, near underneath their own basket. Oh, to a cutting Gonzalez. Ephraim drives to the hole, puts it up, and good. Puts it up over Mardell. BCC has it to within three for the losing it out of bounds.
And here's what they need, the turnover.
Now they got the spark.
Yep.
BCC looking to finish strong. We talked about that bench too, Ben, and fresh bodies.
Yep.
Maybe they're looking to wear Mass Bay down.
Yep.
Nelson underneath.
Oh, goodness, shot.
Gonzalez. That would have been a big shot there.
That would have.
Get a square up to the basket, son.
Yeah,
plenty of time to compose yourself. Kevin Charles. Mass Bay with great ball movement. Oh, nice block there by Gomes. Oh, Martell, how are you just going to let him get to the hoop like that?
Made it look easy. Gets his first 2 points of this half. 5-point lead.
Gonzalez. Nelson on the drive. Dumps it off underneath to Gomes.
Yes.
And we get a foul.
That's going to be big
Nelson
number 10.
Nelson grabbing at his hamstring now. Gomes is going to go to the line, Ben. It's going to be for two.
Yep, and that's going to put him in the double bonus as well. So now every foul, you're going to see two shots for BCC.
We've seen Jerome Gomes take over that first half, and he was presumably, I mean, he was the, you know, he is the main weapon on this team.
Oh, by far.
He was the main factor in the first half of BCC. He needs to be the man down the stretch now. Can't shy away. Both free throws made.
Yep.
Back to a 3-point lead. 4:25.
He's a point away from the 30-point game right now.
If you're just joining us or you've been with us, don't go away. You're in for a hell of an ending here, folks. Jimenez Fox. Down low. Mardell going to his left. Kicks it back out. Kevin Charles, 9 on the shot clock, gets it down to Martell, up the glass,
and they foul him. Boy.
I love the inside-outside game for Mass Bay, the way they're able to penetrate, kick it back out, and also penetrate and find their big man right here, Mr. Gray Mardell. First free throw missed. This BCC crowd starting to come alive a little bit. Do you get it? It's February, folks. It's time for tournament basketball.
It's do or die.
We're a week or two, we're a couple weeks away towards the state tournament. And that free throw sunk in. 70-66 with 4 minutes to play. Ephraim. Here's Gomes. The three. No good. Nice rebound there by Baker. Ephraim takes the three. Goes up. Can't get it to go. Nice rebound by Baker. That would have been a tremendous play, but he couldn't get it to go. Mass Bay lose the basketball.
Yeah, they do.
3:30 left to play. 70-66. $18 shot clock. Nelson for three. Damn it, he got it to go. That's what I'm talking about.
Just when they needed it the most.
Gets it to within
Nelson.
One.
Comes through.
Nelson finally hits from down, way downtown. BCC defense coming alive.
Now it's starting to make Mass Bay nervous.
Oh, Charles in the lane. Get a block from behind by Nelson. Get a piece of that. Nelson, jump shot. Charles. Loose basketball. How does Mass Bay keep coming away with this?
That should be at 11 seconds.
I am not sure what the call is.
I think they got a new shot clock a second time before they were supposed to. Now the ref's conferencing to figure out how to adjust this fairly.
All right, Ben, what's going on?
Basically, what happened was the ball didn't touch the rim. The clock sucked. The shot clock reset.
So we got some more shot clock problems. That's what's going on here. So another delay here in play.
So now they're going to inbound the ball. 14 seconds on the shot clock.
So we have a little bit of a problem with the shot clock resetting itself.
Yep.
Had to see what proper time was going to be placed back on the clock. So, oh, wow. Nice pass to Charles underneath. Loses it. Fox with the rebound, puts it up off the glass. They just can't stop that guy.
He is just a beast underneath.
Pulls up for three. Takes it. We're tied. 72-72.
32 points in the game for Jarrell Gomes. Been a beast tonight.
His 6-3-pointer. We'll see how Mass Bay handles the pressure. Fox going that way.
BCC basketball.
Wow. Fox loses control of that one. Jarrell Gomes, his 6-3-pointer or a 7?
That was his 6-3-pointer. He didn't hit one so far this half except for that one.
Yeah, he was cold, but that 3-pointer couldn't have come at a better time, Ben.
Not at all. Gomes just plays right back up. We got a tie ball
Ephraim,
game.
Taking it to the hole, off the glass.
Gives him the lead.
Gets it to go. Big shot by Ephraim. Crowd coming alive. Here's a trap at half court. Trap at half court by the Bayhawks. Fox Swain. Around the perimeter it goes. And we have a foul. And it looks like it's going to be on Baker.
Yep.
And with that foul, they'll be shooting free throws. So,
yep.
Again, 74-72, the home team. Your Bristol Community College Bayhawks have the lead. So we're coming down to a heck of a finish here, Ben. 74-72.
We got a minute.
What has changed here for BCC to get back into it?
I know they were looking desperate. They were looking like they were falling asleep on the shift. But they just came back to life real quick, and now they are. Yeah, battling back. They got a 2-point lead, a minute 31 to go. This is their game to win now.
Yeah, BCC at times looking a little bit kind of sluggish.
Yeah.
Playing a little bit segmented, playing not a full minute, not a full 40 minutes of basketball.
Yeah.
It seems like, but nonetheless, they found their swerve here in the last few minutes. And they came back from 11 down in the second half, and that free throw is no good.
BCC getting the crowd riled up now.
Yeah, you know what? Mass Bay has done a great job of holding their composure and finding the holes in that BCC zone and finding ways to really get through that, to really pass their way out of that press. Lane violation.
Yep. Now that's going to be a no shot. It's going to be BCC basketball.
Who's that lane violation on? That's a
not
big.
Sure.
That's a big miscue there by MCC.
And that's your sixth man right there making the difference.
All tied. Good to see. Baker underneath. Steven Gonzalez. Loses the basketball.
Wrong time.
Wide
for
open
that.
On the other end. Portillo with the lay-in. We're tied.
Cannot afford.
Big turnover.
Not afford turnovers like that right now.
A minute and 1 second to play. Steven Gonzalez turns the basketball over, and in transition, Mass Bay connects on the other end.
And they tie the game up.
And that's tied the game up. And that sequence, Ben, you can't turn the ball back. You got the lead with, a little bit over a minute to play. You got to lead by a basket. You got to have a good possession there, because at the least, you could take the ball to the hole, you get a foul, and you're going to be shooting free throws.
Exactly. You don't even need to take it to the hole to get the foul.
That's what I'm saying, too.
No matter what, you're getting two shots.
Exactly. Hold the ball.
Exactly.
You know.
Take your time.
Yeah, exactly. Mass Bay is, one little slap here, one reach here, and you're going back to the free throw line. So you got to have a good possession there. So that was kind of careless on their part, but...
It's
74-74.
Actually, we're at Mass Bay now. They're starting to unravel. You're starting to get in their head. They're getting tired. You have the opportunity right now to finish picking them apart and take this home.
Right.
You can't give up easy turnovers like that.
Right. And it was 61-50 at one point. It was 11-point, 11-point difference.
Exactly.
But since then, BCC on a 24-13 run. Here in the last 5 or 6 minutes, BCC has really stepped up and got back into this one.
Definitely.
But nonetheless, we're tied.
Yes, we are.
Minute 1 second left.
BCC ball.
Watching Bayhawks basketball. 1 minute left. The 10th scorer in the nation. Jarrell Combs with the basketball, taking it to his right. Kicks it out to an open Gonzalez. Nelson for three. Gets it to go. At the big three. One possession, 3-point lead for BCC. Wow.
He's drained three threes in a row in the second half.
Crowd going crazy. And Coach Bill Raynor calls a timeout, 77-74. Josh Nelson, we talked about, why wasn't he pulling the trigger before? He had a couple chances earlier in the game. Really wasn't looking for a shot. Really was kind of unconfident. He was kind of quiet throughout this game.
Yeah.
But two massive three-pointers here in the last couple minutes. That one, of course, gives them the lead. That's a big boy shot right there by Mr. Nelson.
Definitely. A clutch, about as clutch as you can get.
Yeah.
When you're tie basketball game with less than a minute to go in the game.
Yeah, this time of year, those are the kind of shots you need.
Exactly.
And this has been a good test. This is a big test for BCC going up against Mass Bay. You know, two teams are comparable to each other, both Bass athletic teams,
mm-hmm.
and both teams that are right up there at the top of Region 21.
Yeah.
So this is a big, big matchup. And when you're getting here down the stretch, you know, this is a good test for them as we climb closer to the postseason.
Yeah, I mean, matching records, matching teams, and, you know, no doubt they're going to see each other again come playoff time. So if they can do it now, they can do it again later.
That's for sure. Like I said, the Bayhawks are holding teams to just 78.1 points per game. That holds mm-hmm. true right now because Mass Bay is 74.
Mm-hmm.
No? And I also give credit to BCC because they really haven't played their best all-around game here today.
Not at
but
all.
They find themselves in a three-point lead with a chance to claim that second spot here
exactly.
in the region.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, that's a real impressive thing. It's the fact that they can win this game, and we're not even seeing them at their best tonight.
Exactly.
We've seen them play much better basketball.
Swain gets it down to Margall, being trapped. Portillo. Back to Swain, puts up the three-pointer, can't get it to go, coming off, Nelson with the rebound. And with 22 seconds left, they'll foul Nelson.
Yep.
And Nelson will step up to the line for two.
And he will.
Josh Nelson, down the stretch here, has been the star. Gotta love that.
Oh yeah, all he needs to do is hit two, and it's a two-possession game, and they basically sealed the deal right here.
No doubt about that. Twenty-two seconds left to play. Ooh, that's a big free throw to make it a two-possession game.
Made it look easy.
Yes. And he makes both free throws. Two-possession game. 22 seconds left to play. BCC doesn't need a foul to do anything stupid.
Nope.
Rebound, put it up the glass, nice block by Nelson. Johnson, what a save.
Nelson just saves the game for BCC. Gets the turnover, going to go to the line to shoot two more. He hits these two. It is absolutely over and done with.
That's a nice hustle play, I tell you what, by Steven Gonzalez.
Definitely,
there. Nice.
Definitely.
Big, big hustle, big play to save that, and
Nelson,
what a block by Nelson.
Huh.
And I like the way we talked about inspired spirit of basketball, and
exactly.
We really didn't see that, kind of segmented today, but down the stretch, they keep it close,
definitely.
And they make that final charge, and that's what they've done here today.
Come to life when it counts.
And they're up to their standard 80 points.
Yeah.
Nearly 85 points a game is their average, and they're keeping Mass Bay below 78 points a game. And just like that, a 7-point lead.
Probably the two most important shots of this
life
right now.
This isn't gonna really mean anything. Tevin Charles doesn't get it. Nelson with the rebound. Gonna come up here and slam it, put the icing on the cake.
Yeah.
It's over with.
That's those two bonus points you were looking for.
Wow. And just like
seals
that,
the
BCC ends in a flourish and ends up with a 9-point victory. Unbelievable how this team played down the stretch. Down 61-50, down 11 halfway through the second half. And your BCC, your Bristol Community College Bayhawks, are second. They are second right now, region 21, and winners of 6 in a row. You've been watching Bayhawks basketball here on FR Media, channel 95 on your Comcast down in the local area. BCC's the victors here, 83-74. What play down the stretch there by BCC. We talked about guys needing to step up. Josh Nelson was one of them. That big three-pointer to make it 77-74. The game was tied there, 74-74 with about a minute left. And BCC ends it on a 9 at the run, iced by that last slam dunk there by Josh Nelson.
And
you know,
how much more of a fitting way to end the game with just a big slam by Josh Nelson.
And the slam by Josh Nelson
comes
Ben.
To life in the second half. Three three-pointers to go along with the other, you know, the other 7 points he put up, plus that dunk to finish it off. I mean, you know, he goes from a game where he was looking at 4 points to start, and he ends the game with almost 20 points.
That's what I mean. And you talk about the way that he played down the stretch, 2 three-pointers there. Oh, hi.
Hey, we're on camera now. Now we can smile at our adoring fans.
Yeah, so anyway, so yeah, we talked about Josh Nelson, the way he stepped up his game down the stretch. And those 2 three-pointers he hit was instrumental in this win. He had the block there at the end. Couple big defensive plays by Josh Nelson, so he really stepped it up. And you can't say enough about all-world, all-nation there. Jarrell Gomes stepping up today with 32 points today, Ben?
Correct, sir.
32 points today, 6 three-pointers. He had 5 of them in the first half. So BCC really hitting their stride as we approach tournament time, postseason time, as we got one more home game left in the season next Tuesday right here at Bishop Conley High School. So again, we talked about how segmented BCC was playing in defensively, but down the stretch, you know, they really were, you know, who we think they are, and that's a vital, you know, postseason threat.
That they are, and you know, not to be outdone, Cameron Jimenez-Fox still had an amazing game. 26 points he put up. He was just a monster underneath, you know, getting rebounds, getting baskets.
He seemingly always had open shots underneath there.
He did BCC, not struggle at all to get shots this game.
BCC seemingly couldn't find an answer for him, because he was seemingly always open underneath, or creating shots underneath, or creating for others underneath. Him and the Ave Gray Mardal, those two were the big boys for Mass Bay. And you know, BCC didn't ever play their best basketball game. They end this game 83-74 after trailing for most of this game.
Oh, definitely. They were down more often than not, but they battled back, and they scored when it meant something. They scored when it was important. That's what you look for too, you know. Not just, you know, you can't always get spirited play 100% of the time, but when you can't get that spirited play, when you can play when it counts, that's what matters too.
And if you're Rob Del Lew, you really got to be encouraged by what you see. You know, you've seen Jarrell Gomes, you know, scoring half the points for this team, you know, for most of the game. And then for guys just to step up out of nowhere, like, you know, Josh Nelson, like we said, you know, guys making hustle plays like Steven Gonzalez over there coming off the bench. We talk about how deep this team is. And Rob Del Lew is very comfortable, you know, playing each and every single one of these guys. You know, Alex Cotton coming off the bench, Kevin Desire, like,
You can see why. They all contribute in their own way, no matter whether they play for 5 minutes or 35 minutes. They all put in their time. They all put in their effort.
Exactly. And they all feel like part of this thing. You know, they're all, you know, all for one. And we talked about them playing together as a team, you know, and that's been the big difference here after the Christmas break. They've really been, you know, playing together as a team, showing teamwork, playing inspired basketball, and playing for each other. And it's a very likable group. They seem to all like each other.
Definitely. They're a team. They are the definition of a team by far.
Well, Rob Del Lew, he talks about, you know, playing your best basketball now. He has a team of usually slow starters, but, you know, to form, Rob Del Lew got this team going, and, you know, and away we go.
Exactly.
A couple weeks here, we're going to have tournament time, so.
We'll be seeing some playoff basketball games.
Okay, so you're watching Bayhawks post game here. 83-74. Your Bristol Community College Bayhawks take this one here at Bishop Conley High School. For Dave Cardoza and Mr. Benjamin Andrews, thank you everybody for watching Bayhawks basketball.
Good night, everybody.